All right, so all the way back, gosh, I don't know. I had to have been 15, 16 years old is when I started paying for microphones, I think. The whole purpose of me buying microphones was to record my drums to make a YouTube video. Now this is back in, I don't know, 2008, 2007, 2008. So yeah, I would have been 16 years old, somewhere around then. And I really didn't know anything about what I should get, how much things cost, how to use it. I was always looking for a simple answer. What's the best fill in the blank mic? What's the best vocal mic? What's the best, like, what's the snare mic? What's the, like, in my head, I thought there's microphones for specific things and you just buy that one. They're like, oh, you buy the kick drum mic or you buy this mic. And it's kind of true. So if I could go all the way back to 2006, 2007, to when I first started acquiring microphones and an audio interface, I think I would have done it a little bit differently. I didn't really understand the concept of mics can be used on different things. It's not as simple as, oh, this is the mic that you use for bass guitar, or this is the mic that you use on this instrument 100% of the time. There's nuance. Microphones can be used on a lot of different things. I didn't know that because I was an idiot. Why am I talking about this? Well, because now, 15 years later, I finally got the mics that I really wish I would have got when I started. I thought I'd share it with you guys. If it's useful, hit the like button or something like that. And to be fair, I don't know if I would necessarily put these microphones in the budget microphone category. These mics can be used for a lot of different things, especially one of them, which is the SM7. But today we're gonna be talking about some microphones from Shure. Shure. All right, so this is the first mic. This is the Beta 52A from Shure. Now this is a supercardioid dynamic microphone, and ironically it says right on the box, kick drum microphone. The second mic is probably the most commonly used mic ever. This is the Shure SM57. Now this is a standard cardioid dynamic microphone. All right, now the next mic I actually did get early on. This is the SM81 by Shure. Let me get my eyes out of the shot here. This is a pencil condenser microphone. This is also a cardioid directional microphone. And because it's a condenser microphone, it's going to be a lot brighter and have more clarity to it. They sound great on instruments like acoustic guitar, shakers, again, cymbals and drum overheads, and sometimes even drum rooms. You can use them on things like bongos or tambourine, stuff like that. It sounds really, really great. Now for one of my favorite microphones that I wish I would have started with. I'm excited for this one. The SM7. These things are freaking great. It's almost annoyingly great. You've seen them on every podcast ever. They're used in broadcast radio. They're used for live performances. They're just all around super durable. Now this is amazing for buttery, smooth, mid-range. These microphones work on just about everything. In fact, it's kind of annoying how great they are. I use these on, obviously, for vocals. They are an amazing vocal mic. In the mix, they cut right through and they sit just perfectly. And not surprisingly, a fantastic close mic for drums, on kick drum, on snare drum, on hi-hat. Really smooth hi-hat mic. Love it, absolutely use it all the time on hi-hat. Great on, obviously, guitar cabinets. I've used it on a bass guitar cabinet. The mid-range is fantastic. I've used it on acoustic guitar and again, shot it out. The way that I work is when we're going to record something, I want to try a few different microphones on the source first and see what sounds best for the song. And I can't tell you how annoying it is that this mic just works all the time. Now, because this mic is so freaking useful, specifically for me, Shure and Sweetwater were kind enough to send over some microphones, and I'm gonna try them out, and I'm gonna use them just like if I was starting 15 years ago and see what I was missing out on. Some of these mics I already had, and then a couple others they sent to me. They sent me this Beta 52, a couple SM7s, and then this one I'm really excited about. This is the Beta 91A. So this is actually called a boundary microphone. It's half cardioid and it's a condenser. Now, what's cool about this is you can use it for, you can use it for all kinds of stuff, but the thing that's interesting to me that I want to use it for, look at this thing. Looks like the Cybertruck. Just got your little XLR port here and it just sits on the ground. Don't even put it on a stand. So depending on the circumstance, the song, the drums you're using, this is a freaking awesome kick drum mic. Now this is gonna get you a lot of slap. So if you're looking to get a lot of that hard hitting, punchy slap sound, this is the mic to go with. Now in my experience, typically when I use this, you're gonna need something else in addition to it, like a sub kick. So I'll check that out. I'm really excited about that. Okay, so I got my tracks made in Pro Tools here, and I am gonna play along to a new song called Last Train Home, which is from John Mayer, if you haven't heard it. Instant classic, perfect pop tune. Aaron Sterling plays drums on this. He is like, you know, and I'm like somewhere down here probably. But this is a really fun song, and I just, this is what I got into this mess to do, is to just screw around playing drums to my favorite songs and record it. So let's do it. Let's see what these drums sound like through these mics to Last Train Home. Okay, let's check out what they sound like. Let's go mic by mic first. We'll do kick mic. Classic Beta 52 sound. So this is such a familiar kick drum, bass drum sound. Concerts, a lot of records this has been used on. It's very, very familiar to my ears. I mean, it's just one mic, right dead center, basically no effort put into it. Sounds awesome. And let's add in the snare. Okay, that's the SM7 on snare. The drums sound good on their own. I'll say that just to be fair. This is a vintage 65 Slingerland. It's a Studio King model, and the snare drum is a Black Beauty that was put together by CNC. It's the Ludwig Black Beauty shell, and it just sounds awesome. I'm also very biased because these are my drums. I tune them how I like them, and I love that. It sounds really, really great. SM7, I feel like not a lot of people think to use it on drums, but it sounds so killer. I actually took it from this guy, Kurt Schneider, who's actually ironically engineered the drums on the song I'm playing to. And Aaron Sterling played. I did a session with the both of them some years back, and he used the SM7 on kick and snare, and it just sounded so good. Okay, now let's listen to the overheads with the kick and the snare. Obviously, right away, so much clarity to the image of the drum kit, so much wider stereo mics, condensers. I've actually had the SM81s for, I don't know, 10 plus years and used them as my overheads, and they are fantastic. Okay, so let's add in the hi-hat, which is the SM7. So now we have Beta 52 on kick, SM7 on snare, SM7 hi-hat, SM81s on the overheads. Listen to how warm and smooth those hi-hats sound. Yes, So good. Okay, and then the last is just the toms, which I just threw 57s on, and I edited them. There's like no fills in this song, so we'll do this. Wow, okay. Little pre-roll here. Here we go. I don't know what else you need. This song is basically the same thing. I'm hitting pretty hard on the kit, and it's just a groove the whole time. It's pretty much the same groove. I put a couple fills in there, but they're not. I don't think there's any fills in this song. But just to hear something a little different, I jumped over to the right at the end, so let's check that out. See that stereo imaging? So nice. I love the overheads over the toms like that. All right, let's hear what this sounds like with the actual track. Obviously, I mean, it's kind of silly to compare this, but this is, I just love this. If I were to do, like, let's say a drum cover, this is sort of what it would sound like. Oh, let me throw the reverb back on here. What am I using? I have the Lexicon 40L on the rooms, setting to large rooms. Pretty good. Let's jump a little further into the song. What do you guys think? Do you guys use these mics? I mean, I feel like these are super common mics, and I just, for whatever reason, got different mics when I started, and I really wish I would have started with these. This is such a great handful of mics. Sure, just like figured it out, and the combination of all of them together, they really work well together. This was that same part without the track. Let's see, just all the mics together. I mean, it just sounds so good. I mean, this is basically what we're hearing here is really five mics because the toms aren't, I have them all cut out until the fills. So it's really just five mics, two SM7s, Beta 52, and two SM81s. That's what I would recommend if you are a drummer or someone who, you know, this is really a great arsenal to have to do really anything in a project studio or home studio. Definitely an affordable route. I wouldn't even put these in the category of budget mics, but they are really affordable. So to be fair, relative to, you know, a 251 or, you know, more expensive microphones, you get these and you can get killer sounds. I'm just using the Apollo X mic pre's here. And then on the overheads, I'm using the Warm Audio 1073s. But they sound so good. Just as is. I think the Unison plugin that I used is the, I can see here if I flip over to console, is the Neve 1073. So this is the kick setting I had, and this is the snare setting that I had. And I mean, that's it. The hi-hat was this one. So just basically down. I forgot to turn it up because I'm lazy. But yeah, so just one Unison pre on each input, and they sounded great, and I'm really, really excited about this. So let me know what you guys think. Do you guys use Shure mics on drums? What's your favorite? How do you use it? I forgot to use the, what is it, the 91. I'm going to do another video on that. Maybe do like a kick drum mic placement shootout. Super stoked to have these in the arsenal. Going to use them on a bunch of other stuff. I use the SM7s on everything. They're freaking awesome. So thank you again to Sweetwater and Shure for setting this up. Thank you guys for watching. Hit the like button if you guys like these videos. Also, I think we're almost at 50,000 subscribers. So if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. I'm going to set a hasty goal of getting 100,000 subscribers by the end of 2021. Probably not going to be able to do it. But if you share the video, if you like it, subscribe, all that stuff, it really, really helps me. And I appreciate you guys. You guys are freaking awesome. And I'll see you in the next video. See ya.